You got to be able to listen to your membership and your leadership, because if you're not listening to your membership and your leadership, you're not doing your job.
He was my dad's committee man. And my dad said to me, I got this young kid, and when I ask him questions, he always gets back to me, right? He'll take my question, you know, he'll go find the answer, and then he'll come back and he'll give me an answer. He says, he's really good. I said, well, who's that, Dad? He says, oh, this kid named Jeff Benz. I said, oh, great.
I made sure that I treated everybody the way I wanted to be treated. You listen to people, you treat people with respect, you could go anywhere you want in this union.
I think Jeff has well over 20 years. He's been working for the staff of the UAW and the membership. You know, Jeff had come up through the system. He was a shop committeeman, worked in CAP. He had worked with retired workers. He then served on the executive board, and today now serves on the international executive board.
I never cared about a title. I just cared about doing the job.
Most inspiring piece about Jeff Benz was his transition from the role that he'd been involved in. He had already touched the majority of his region and a lot of other parts of the country, met people. So Jeff was a good representative for Region 9. I think he's been a great director for Region 9, huge advocate for them, and a guy who's not afraid to stand up in the tough times and not afraid to call the question.
Jeff is a very steady, thoughtful board member,
but he's persistent. He'll stay on it and dig into it.
Someone that you can rely on, true blue. He is a soldier in solidarity on the board.
Good guy, solid. You could call on, ask to assist with anything, and he's the guy who will tell you, I got your back, and he means I've got your back.
You know, Jeff has served this membership really well for a lot of years. Many will miss him in his role as regional director.
Dedicated to the cause, and that's not going to stop when he retires. He's still going to be involved because that's his dedication.
And my plan is when I retire to have a boat out back and go crabbing, fishing, and really enjoy life. But I have always said to President Curry that if he ever needs me in retirement, I will come out and do anything I can for this great union.